tonight on Crippled News. Streamer war has begun. TwitchCon happened last week and was raided by kick streamers who harassed fans, staff, and stars. We have the full breakdown of the disaster. If they weren't hated enough, Mr. Beast, Logan Paul, and KSI have launched a new product for kids. Is it good or is it poison? We have the full details. They have done it again. Ubisoft comes under fire over their latest game. Assassin's Creed Shadows is so bad that they are conducting an internal investigation. And we have the full breakdown that starts now.
When all hope is gone and the truth is under attack, there's only one place to get the true news, Crippled News. With your host, Ricky Berwick.
Hey, if you like Crippled News, make sure you like, comment, and subscribe. It really helps. Now, on to the show. Folks, it's time to talk about one of the most innovative game developers of our generation, Ubisoft. You know, the company that releases a new Assassin's Creed game every year that nobody asked for. Their latest installment, Assassin's Creed Shadows, continues to be surrounded by controversy and delays. After months of backlash from the gaming community over the game's plot, characters, gameplay, and DLC, Ubisoft has announced that the game will be delayed until early 2025. The game has come out under fire from the gaming community over one of the main playable characters, Yasuke. Many Japanese historians believe he was just a sword carrier and never actually a real samurai. The only information we know about Yasuke comes from the single book written by some British guy who has been called out by other Japanese historians as a fraud. The fraud's name is Thomas Lockley, a former professor at Neon University. He was caught editing academic papers and Wikipedia articles to fit his narrative. He wrote a book about the supposed samurai, admitting he had to fill in the blanks. One Japanese YouTuber breaks down the lies of Thomas Lockley.
Began with Wikipedia. A lot of the stuff you see on Twitter, YouTube, and online articles actually comes from Wikipedia, but a lot of that information was wrong. It all goes back to October 22, 2012. Someone added a sentence to Wikipedia that said, "When Nobunaga was convinced that this person really had dark skin, he valued him highly, named him Iyasuke, and kept him close." This sentence wasn't true and caused a lot of confusion. Then on June 14, 2013, someone changed the Wikipedia article again. It now said, "He was officially made a Bushido warrior and kept close." This change made people think that Yasuke had become a samurai, and that's how the legend of Yasuke, the Black Samurai, was born. The next day, on June 15, another line was added to the Wikipedia article. It said, Nobunaga liked Yasuke so much that he intended to make him a lord in the future. In just one day, Yasuke had been promoted to a future lord, but this was completely false. So, from 2012 to 2024, Yasuke was indeed considered a samurai on the internet. Then something interesting happened. On January 25, 2017, Thomas Lockley, an associate professor at Nihon University, published a book called Nobunaga and Yasuke. Later, on May 2, 2019, the same author released Iyasuke, the true story of the legendary African samurai. First foreign-born samurai, and his astonishing journey from Northeast Africa to the heights of Japanese society. This book was actually co-authored by Lockley and another writer. It's a 400-page novel, and most of it is fiction. After investigating, they realized that Thomas Lockley was just making things up. And where did Thomas Lockley, who wrote the novel, learn about Yasuke? From none other than Wikipedia.
So Ubisoft's first real historical character is based off of dodgy Wikipedia articles. Wow, Ubisoft. Great job. If you think Ubisoft can be more disrespectful to the Japanese, think again. As a promotion, Ubisoft released a figurine of two main characters on a half-broken gate, which looks a lot like the one-legged Tori Shrine. For those who don't know, Tori Shrine is one of the last remnants of the Nagasaki bombing. To put this into perspective, To put this into perspective, that's like if Sony released a figurine with Spider-Man in the Two Towers. Great job, Ubisoft. No wonder why he came out this past Wednesday and delayed the game until February. Ubisoft stocks are taking a bad hit so much that they have launched an internal investigation in hopes to turn things around. I bet they wish they did that sooner. I'm sure Star Wars Outlaws wouldn't have been so buggy. Or Shadows would be more historically accurate. But let's be real. Assassin's Creed isn't really about history anymore. It's about parkouring through ancient cities while constantly asking yourself, wait, did I already do this 6 games ago? So, should you buy Assassin's Creed Shadows in February? Sure, as long as you got $70 to spend and nothing better to do for the next 60 hours. And hey, if the game glitches and says there are assassins floating off into the void, just remember, it's not a bug. It's Ubisoft. It's been a hellish couple of months for Mr. Beast. After allegations have come out from former employees claiming he fakes his videos, rigs competitions, and has predators on staff. Recently, Jimmy has been sued by former contestants on his new Amazon show, alleging abuse and harassment. After months of silence, many of us thought we would never hear an official statement from Mr. Beast addressing all the controversy until now. September 16th, he finally spoke. Did he address the controversy? No! He launched a new knockoff Lunchables product with other star influencers, Logan Paul and KSI.
Lunchly versus Lunchables.
With Lunchly, you get double the amount of liquid.
Prime has no sugar added, more electrolytes, and more B vitamins.
Crunch Bar. Whoa. Feastables Crunch
Bar. Yeah!
Our pizza uses real cheese. Theirs, as it says on their box, is mozzarella pasteurized prepared cheese product. Mm. They can't even call it real cheese.
Ooh,
Turkey Stack'em, 310 calories.
230 calories.
21 grams of sugar. If you look at this close-up, you can already tell which one has better ingredients. All right, we'll start off with the Lunchables.
Bro, I'm sorry, that's trash. All right, now we're trying Lunchly. Come on.
We're not biased at all, but ours is way better.
Fiesta Nachos.
Come in close and look at the queso cheese in Lunchly versus whatever that is.
Oh, drip versus stick.
I like my cheese drippy, bro.
This is a Lunchly salsa right here. Look at the consistency, the texture. And this is Lunchables. This, look, it's watery. It's, I can't even look at that.
With 400 milligrams of electrolytes, my God!
And it's available for around $4.
The internet was quick to come out and criticize the trio, mocking them for their attempt at a quick buck in marketing garbage as a healthy alternative. Popular YouTuber Dr. Mike gives his take on the legitimacy of the health benefits from Lunchly.
Fair to say that Lunchly is healthier. I guess one can say yes, but honestly, probably more so as a marketing tactic. The reason why? Well, let's look at the recently passed nutrition standards set forth by the USDA for school lunches and see how Lunchly compares. Going line by line here, less than 10% of calories should come from saturated fat. Lunchly turkey, 23% of calories come from saturated fat. Less than 10% of calories should come from added sugars. Lunchly turkey, 10.4 comes from added sugars. But this is where things get really interesting, and for some reason, no one has pointed this out. You see, USDA caloric guidelines say that a lunch meal for kids K through 8 should contain around 625 calories. Kids need energy to function, and calories give them that energy. Lunchly turkey contains only 230 calories, which would mean a kid would need to eat about 2.7 portions to consume enough calories. And if they did that, they'd get nearly 1,300 milligrams of sodium, which is also significantly over the USDA standards. So they'd be either under-eating calories or overeating sodium.
But what about the taste? Surely these giant influencers wouldn't put their name on an inferior product, would they? Here's a clip of Asmongold doing a live comparison.
Guys, I feel like this is so anticlimactic. They're basically the same thing. They look different, but they basically taste the exact same. Like, the cheese here is a completely different color, and guess what? They probably both use food coloring in these. It's basically the f***ing same. I'm sorry. It's not crazy, but which one edges out? I think it depends on the drink. If you like Prime, then it's going to be Prime. If you like Capri Sun, it's going to be Lunchables. Other than that, I really can't say. I think that they're pretty much about the same thing.
As the product was being exposed and the trio was facing a wave of criticism, KSI released a reaction video to the controversy, giving some fair points and why he thinks Lunchly is getting so much hate.
Where was the same energy when Ryan Trahan released Sweet? Where was the same energy when FaZe Rogue released Sweet? Now, I'm not throwing them under the bus because I tried both of their sweets and it's fantastic. It's actually one of the best, like, sweets I've had in a long time, especially American sweets. Like, it's a shame that, you know, I can't even get it in England. But anyway, I'm not seeing people going crazy towards them on Twitter. You know why? I've realized why. It's because people just hate us. People just hate us. People hate Logan Paul, okay? They hate Mr. Beast and they hate me.
He's not wrong. There hasn't been a band of villains like this since the Sinister Six. The majority of people who are above 15 don't like them. That being said, these guys offering an unhealthy food product to kids isn't that evil. I'm sure some of you right now are eating chips or fast food as you watch Cripple News. Where is the race towards Lay's and McDonald's, damn it? You know, I think I'm gonna sell out like these guys and make trash products for kids. It's my turn to get the bag. Well, guess what? Cripple News is excited to announce our new product. This sucks.
Bored with the latest influencer products, kiddo?
Yeah.
Well, don't you worry, because Cripple News has got you covered with this new shiny box of sh.
Wow, golly gee willigan.
That's right, this shiny box of sh has 0 calories, 0 sugar. In fact, it has 0 use at all.
Why would I buy it?
Because it has our name on the side, you stupid f***. Now give us your money.
Okay.
Shiny box of sh** is now in all Walmarts and Targets.
TwitchCon 2024 happened last week, bringing fans and streamers together for a weekend packed with live events, fun activities, and drug use. What was set up to be a fun weekend for everyone quickly turned sour. Shocking! Who would have thought an event filled with narcissists and sicko fans would have no controversy? But as it went on, there was a common theme being established. Many kick streamers who attend TwitchCon were filmed harassing fans and other Twitch streamers. Here's a clip from kick streamer Slightly Homeless stalking popular Twitch streamers Extra Emily and Emiru.
I mean, I know they're in the main hall based on the floor. Oh, they're at the dance thing. All right, I know where they're at. I'm sorry, big fan. I want to say hi. How are you?
I'm great. Oh, is your stream?
Yeah. I'm Carlina.
You're what?
Carlina.
Carlina?
Yeah.
Yeah, nice to meet you.
Goodbye. Hi, Emily. Nice to meet you. You are hot.
Huh?
You're hot.
Wow, thank you.
Yeah.
You as well.
Yeah.
Are
no,
we
really?
Oh, yeah.
What?
We're going to go now. Thank you.
One question.
Yes.
Either of you marry me.
No.
The creepy behavior didn't end there. Here's one kick streamer trying to lick another Twitch streamer.
Okay, okay. Oh.
All right, let's not do any more of that.
Thank you.
Okay.
Thank you.
Nice to meet you, big boy, though. Sorry.
Thank you. Oh.
The next day, the same streamer stalked Twitch megastar Mizkif and harassed him.
Mizkif, what do you think about Knut admitting you covered up? Well, that's crazy. And I have it on video. Huh? That's crazy, right? Really is crazy. Look at this cover up. You're covering up again. Covering up again is crazy. It's a crazy thing to cover up.
Brother, you licked Nick's nipple the other day.
I did. And I did it publicly. Publicly. With consent. Don't touch me, sir.
No.
Hey, Miss Kev.
No.
Oh, wow. I love this. I love this sex. They got like a... I could juke you, motherfucker. They just fuck. I got like mad security. I got mad security on me. It's great.
That wasn't the only time Miss Kiff was harassed. Popular streamer Bruce Drop Him Off had some choice words for Miz.
Yo, we at TwitchCon right now. He's still f***ing blocked. He's still a but it's okay, you know.
That's not what you're gonna say at all.
I wasn't supposed to say this. He's still blocked though. I haven't unblocked.
He's talking more. End it.
And the cringe doesn't end there, folks. Take a look at this streamer pushing someone into a moving train.
So it's like you're backing your boy.
Simple as that.
Yeah, you're backing your boy? Yeah. Oh, chill, bro. What the f***, bro? What the f***? Chill out, bro. That's dangerous. Bro, that's not a joke. What? That's a train, bro. That's a train. Chill.
There are many disgusting clips like this. Clips of streamers fighting, hitting on 12-year-olds. And other cringe actions. Major streamers have come out and condemned the poor behavior of the Kick Gang, such as popular Twitch streamer Tectone.
Harassing innocent people for no f***ing reason. It's a joke. It's a joke. The fact that Extra Emily had to run away from a Kick streamer because she felt unsafe is insane. Not once, but twice. Another streamer going up to Nick, sucking on his nipples, licking Wake's hand. It's insane. It's insane. And the only thought that I've had in my head is, damn, I wish I was there when it happened. I mean, there's people pushing people into moving trains.
Streaming superstar Ludwig thinks this is a Kick issue and that the platform breeds this type of streamer. He came out and said this. I think it's poison. There's a bunch of streamers on the platform. Every platform has bad eggs, but why does Kick breed so many bad eggs? Eddie, one of the co-founders of Kick, has come out and condemned the actions of the Kick streamers, even giving out bans. However, Speed Talker XQC believes this is not enough and there should be harsher punishments.
I know they're getting banned. But it's not even just that, though, dude. It's about everything. I wish people understood, like, It's not just getting, it's just about like fixing the culture, man. Like, make sure this doesn't happen more. Make sure people get the point that this is bad. Like, there really needs to happen. Yeah, this is like repercussions, but we need like actual sizable repercussions. A ban will never make somebody click. Dude, if you have the point where you go to IRL events, brother, and you suck on people's like, live on air, brother, okay, is not like, what are you saying, 8 hour? Dude, a ban isn't gonna fix that gap in mental or restraint, dude. Like, you need added repercussions. That's
welcome back, brother.
Insane. Any of these guys were able to do what they were doing it.
Not all Kick streamers who attended the event acted like assholes. One in particular is popular streamer Action Man, who was minding his own business until he got kicked out.
We're gonna escort you out.
We're gonna escort it out?
Yes.
Okay. What did I do?
We'll just leave.
We're leaving. Wait, what do you guys need me to do?
We're gonna need to see the credentials.
Credentials, alright, here. Right here, man.
Yeah.
Okay.
Yeah, we don't.
What did I do wrong, though?
Well,
it came from our command center. It's probably a code of conduct thing. So.
Code of conduct.
Remember when you signed all that code of conduct?
Yeah. What did I do wrong?
Let's. You mind putting that out? Because we're gonna have to go back in the building. Real
okay, guys. We're leaving right now. Sorry about that. I'm not trying to bother y'all, bro.
Thank you. We appreciate it.
My bad.
Walk out.
We're walking out. Sorry about that, bro. Sorry.
As the clip shows, staff claim he broke the code of conduct. However, if you watch the full stream, nothing major happens. Was he collateral damage due to the poor behavior of his peers? We did have a scheduled interview with Action Man to get his take. However, he decided to do a catch a PDF stream, which got him banned on Kick. I gotta say, folks, Ludwig's comments about Kick does have merit. But let's not pretend Twitch is any better. There are countless douches on the platform. Sure, they help expose Doc, but the way they handled it makes me think they covered for other predators. When I look at the current streamer scene, I gotta ask, what's worse for society? Hot tub streams or harass the public streams? Tell me what you guys think is worse in the comments. I think we should burn them both down. That's it for this episode of Cripple News. If you want to help support the channel, make sure you go to our merch store at merch.rickybroick.com. Or if you want a personal shout out from me, go to my Cameo. If you want to become a producer of the show, make sure you go to patreon.com/rickybroick.